Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In today's lecture, we shall be discussing inflammatory conditions of the skin. We shall be starting with hidradenitis suppurativa, which is also known as acne inversa. It is a chronic, inflammatory, recurrent, debilitating skin disease of the hair follicle. It usually presents at puberty with painful, deep-seated, inflamed lesions in apocrine gland-bearing areas of the body. There are double comedones, deep sinus tracts, and abscesses, which are the characteristics of hidradenitis suppurativa. It is most commonly seen in axilla, inguinal, and anogenital regions. Well, how does the hidradenitis suppurativa presents? Initially, it presents as a painful nodule in axilla or groin. Then, it persists as painless nodule that flares repeatedly over months or turns into a discharging abscess with worsening pain. Some lesions show chronic purulent discharge. Over time, more sites are involved, and in some cases, there is progression to deep sinus tract and cord-like scarring of the affected area, which causes disfigurement and pain. Patients with extensive disease have usually had symptoms for years, and chronic sinuses occasionally results in development of squamous cell carcinoma. Well, it is said in uncontrolled hidradenitis suppurativa that it can progress into fistulated, hard to treat lesions. And the specialists say that we should not let our patient reach this clinical stage of hidradenitis suppurativa. What is the cause of hidradenitis suppurativa? The cause is unknown yet, but there are still theories that we believe in. It develops when hair follicles become blocked and inflamed. It is usually unknown why this blockage occurs. Number of factors including hormones, family history, age and sex, they may all play a role. Blockage might occur when sweat is trapped inside the sweat gland tubes, which eventually swells up and either burst or becomes severely inflamed. There is a link between hidradenitis suppurativa and both smoking and obesity. Hidradenitis suppurativa is not contagious, it is not caused by poor hygiene, and it is not caused by poor nutrition. This is the clinical presentation. The differential diagnosis of hidradenitis suppurativa is extensive, but can easily be differentiated from other diseases by the age of onset and characteristic location of the lesions. These are the differential diagnosis of early lesions and late lesions. Prognosis and disease complications. The risk of squamous cell carcinoma and other malignancies may be increased in those with hidradenitis suppurativa. Contractures, strictures, serious infections, and anemia are also important sequelae. In complications, we have anal, urethral, and rectal strictures and fistulas. Patient may have anemia. Contractures may develop that may limit the limb mobility. Squamous cell carcinoma may develop in chronic lesions. Risk of other malignancies may be increased in such patients. Lumbosacral epidural abscesses may develop. Sacral bacterial osteomyelitis may occur. Now, how do we treat hidradenitis suppurativa? We give the patient antibiotics. Retinoids are helpful. Some hormonal therapy can be given. Immunosuppressive and anti-inflammatory agents are given. Neurotoxins play an important role. Radiotherapy, radiofrequency, and other procedures are there. and in surgery, we lay open the sinus tract. We can give the patient radiotherapy or we can go for a wide excision. I'll be happy to answer any questions if you have. And in our next lecture, we shall be discussing gangrene, cellulitis, and lymphadenitis. Thank you so much for today.